A local doctor accused of contaminating IV bags at a surgery center in Dallas. As investigators say, those compromised bags resulted in the death of another doctor and left several patients with health issues. Ariel Placencia is live outside Baylor Scott & White this morning, and this case is now being handled at the federal level.
Yeah, that's exactly right, Mark. And we are still waiting for federal authorities to release more information about the specific charges that Dr. Raynaldo Ortiz is facing. He is expected to make his first court appearance tomorrow. Here's what we do know, though. There are at least seven victims who came here for a routine surgical procedure at Baylor Scott & White Surgicare, North Dallas. Their attorney tells me that those victims, they're almost all under the age of 40, and they all had very similar stories.
All in good health, no major underlying issues whatsoever. And they found themselves being rushed to a major hospital because they had to be intubated and ventilated because they suffered respiratory distress and cardiac arrest.
Now, the Texas Medical Board temporarily suspended Ortiz's medical license, saying surveillance video shows the doctor putting IV bags into a warmer outside operating rooms right before a patient suffered a medical issue, and that tiny holes were later found poked in the plastic wrap around the bags. We also talked to the attorney representing the family of Dr. Melanie Casper, an anesthesiologist who had worked here at Surgicare North Dallas. She took a saline bag from this facility home with her to treat herself for dehydration. According to documents, she gave herself the IV and almost immediately had a serious cardiac event and died. Attorney Don Tittle told us that Casper's husband is relieved to hear that progress is being made on the investigation. In a statement, he said, quote, "There really is little doubt that Melanie Casper's death was the result of an IV bag that had been tampered with." Now, Baylor Scott & White set up a hotline, a phone number for patients who have questions and think they might be affected to call. That number is 214-818-2794. And Mark and Kara, we've also posted that over on our website.